Oh, sorry guys. Hello, welcome to Swingy Steve's Bargain Beer Reviews. Right, so I'm not very well today. I'm not terrible, don't worry, I've got coronavirus, I don't think, anyway. I've got a bit of a cold, so I can't smell, so I'm not going to do a beer review because I won't be doing it any justice. What I'm going to do is a review on a box set of beers that I bought just before Christmas. Actually, my wife got it, mate, as a Christmas present. She said, you know, Steve, knock yourself out, it's a Christmas present. I went to a bottle shop. And they did a 12 Days of Christmas bottle collection. It looks something like this. The little flaps that open up like that. You've got little beers behind it. Just like that on the other side. For those of you who don't know what one looks like. So I thought I'll do a bit of review of this. Because it wasn't expensive. I think it was £25 for 12 beers. And I thought that was pretty good. And some of these are locally sourced. Some of them weren't locally sourced to Yorkshire. Some of them are festive beers. Some of them are in the vein of festivity. I won't necessarily call them festive beers. So that brings me on to my first beer. So the first beer, you had a little bit of a glimpse of it then, is this one. Timothy Taylor Bolt Maker. Now, I've had this on cask before, and on cask, it's a lovely beer. A really nice session beer. What is it coming in? It comes in at about 4.2%. Sessionable, just about for sessionable. I'm not going to read all the stuff about it. What I'm going to do is quickly, basically, in this review is 12 beer reviews. All right, so you're going to get 12 brief, pretty brief beer reviews. I don't think I've reviewed this properly before. Now, in the bottle, a little bit disappointed, I'm not going to lie. I found it a little bit thin, a little bit gassy, actually. And it didn't have the body that it has on cask. It didn't have the smoothness. And it is one of these beers, I think, that does really work well on cask, but doesn't translate that well to the bottle. That being said, it was nice enough. I gave it a 7.7. Now, 7.7 on my indicator is still a very good beer. And it was a very good beer. A nice one to get the ball rolling. But like I say, it doesn't translate as well as it does on cask, this beer. It's a nice balance. It's very malt forward. It's all about the malts, this beer. So, yeah, a decent malty beer. Number two was this one. And this one is Pennine Brewery. Now, they bring this out every year, Pennine Brewery. Really decent brewery. Pennine Brewing Co. A Beedale. So in Derbyshire. I think it's Derbyshire Beedale, isn't it? Or is it Yorkshire Dales? Might be Yorkshire Dales. I don't know. Anyway, you can look that one up when you get home. I don't dare say people will want to comment. Jingle Bell Rock. Was it a Christmas beer? But it was a very nice beer. It was very nice and refreshing. Quite a crisp beer, actually. Hop forward. Relatively balanced, but more of a hop forward beer. I gave this beer, what did I give it out of 10? I gave this an 8.1 out of 10. I think that was just an excellent beer. It was really refreshing, really well balanced. very traditional British hops used in it. I enjoyed it. It was nice, actually. So I was drinking quite a lot of heavy beers over Christmas. So it was nice to have something that was a little bit lighter. A bit more refreshing. So, door number three. Right, so. Is that one? Yeah. So this one was Torside Brewing. Six hop IPA. Clampdown. These are based in New Mills, Derbyshire. I think this was the one that was unconditioned. Let's have a little look. Yeah, it was unconditioned. Or cask conditions, unconditioned. It's not air. It was bottle conditioned. It says, yeah, pour gently. Fantastic IPA. Fantastic. Really full bodied. A bit floating around in it. It had got continental hops in it. It tasted to me like there were some English hops in there as well. 6.8%. Top quality stuff, this. Really nice. I gave that a 9. A 9 out of 10. Really, I remember this one. Really cloudy. It reminds me of like how I remember when these cloudy IPAs first started coming back into fashion again about 5 or 6 years ago. Probably longer now, actually. And they were all in bottles at that time. It reminds me of that a little bit. It reminds me when Thwaites Brewery were doing their, I can't remember what their little craft brewery side project was, but when they started doing stuff, reminded me a bit of that. So yeah, anyway, top brewery. Well, maybe a top brewery, I don't know. I'm guessing so if the beers are like that, but a top beer. That was Clampdown 6 Hop IPA. Right, number 4. What was this one? Ah. Okay, so Daleside Santa's Progress. What did I give this one? Okay, so beers of distinction, a golden beer with dark malts and seasonal fruits. Yeah, interesting one, this one. There's one of them that had orange peel in it. I'm not sure if it was this one. No, it was, yeah, golden, dark malts. Yeah, it was a nice beer. It was a bit like a mild almost. I don't know, it has a mild quality to it. Yeah, it was, I mean, calls itself a golden beer, but actually it had quite like dark fruit flavours in it. So it was a bit of a, almost like an oxymoron in itself. It was like, it came across, it looked like it was going to be quite a light beer, but it came across like a mild, if I remember rightly. 4.2%. I give it 4.9 out of 10. Not quite an excellent beer, but a very, very good, very, very good beer. And I did enjoy that. So there we go, Santa's Progress. And that brings me on to number 5. Oh, I kind of wish I were drinking these again now. Oof, yes, now. I give this one, yeah. Loch Lomond Brewery, Silky Stout. I really enjoyed this oatmeal stout. I thought this was lovely. Really, really nice. Very, very, very smooth. Nice body to it. Nice, lovely little chocolatey malts going off in there as well. Yeah, it says roast chocolate malt. I'm having to remember what it tasted like, but I do remember this one. Remember this one really like surprising me quite a lot, because I picked up something and it was going to be quite thin, in fact, and it wasn't. It was a really lovely, thick-bodied stout, quite velvety. And I gave this one an 8.5 out of 10, so middle of excellent. Wasn't an outstanding beer. It was an excellent beer though. Really, really nice. I would definitely recommend that to anybody. And that kind of put you in the Christmas spirit a little bit, you know. Number 6 next. So this is Hebden Bridge. I remember now. Yeah, Fruity Hazy. A great beer that runs deep. Let me just read through it again. I can't remember what this was. I can tell you what score I gave it. Heaven's Wheat bottle. Right, yeah, I remember now. It is a Belgian wheat beer. That's right. Really nice. I really enjoyed this. I give it an 8. I'd just give it a solid 8 out of 10. Just an excellent beer. Nice body to it. 4.5%. Wheat beers, a bit hit and miss with them, especially when they're not brewed overseas. I always find when British breweries try to create wheat beers, I always find them a little bit acidic, or the body don't quite follow through. But I really enjoyed that. I thought it was quite refreshing as well. Maybe it'd be quite a refreshing beer. I drank this one in the bath. There we go. Right. 6. Hold on, 7. We're halfway through now. Some people are thinking, thankfully, people have always switched off. Right, this one. Now, what do I give this one? This is Farmers Belgian Blue. Farmers Brewery for me are going down a little bit. Now, a lot of people have complained about their bottle beers in particular tasting of diacetyl, so which is a cleaning fluid that's used in the brewing process. Oh, no, sorry, it's not the cleaning fluid. Sorry, I digress. It's a bacteria that grows in the brewing process if it's not brewed at the right temperature, I think, if that's right. Maybe I'm wrong on that one, so someone might want to correct me. But Bradfield Brewery, it's a purple colour, this beer. And I must admit, I had an headache after drinking it. Maybe it was because it was Christmas and my diet probably wasn't as good as it should have been. But this one, not quite what it used to be. Now, on cask, I do remember really enjoying this and drinking it, but a couple of years ago I drunk it and I'm like, it is, it's 4.9% now. It used to be 5.5%, this beer. So that, for me, it's gone down a little bit. I don't think that's great. I think that's a bit of a blemish now in there. Well, maybe the rest of the beers are a bit iffy as well. I wasn't keen on that. Well, it was okay. I gave it a 6.8 out of 10, which is top of okay. Top of okay. It was an okay beer, but I was disappointed. It didn't have any of the qualities that it used to have, you know. It just tasted a bit... It was malty, it was a little bit bready, but it was a bit thin and a bit... weren't bothered. Anyway, moving on to number 8. Ah, yes. So, Saltaire, White Christmas. So this one picked me up a little bit. Now, I've drunk this one before. This is a regular, it seems, now with Saltaire Brewery. And this is a Christmassy beer for sure. A festive citrus spice pale ale. It's got orange peel and that brewed in this one, I think. And it worked quite nicely. It's quite a nice malt. It got, again, nice balance with the malts as well. But yeah, the citrusy, the orange citrusiness came through quite well. I gave this one a 7.9 out of 10. Thought that was a good beer. I quite like that one. I would definitely get that again. What was next? Again, not quite excellent, just a very, very, very good beer. Oh, hold on, 8. King's Citra Hop. Another one. Yeah, just give this 8 out of 10, so just excellent. So it's in that sort of range. A Mighty Oak Brewery, King's... Citra Hops are very... If you ever buy a beer called Citra by the Oakham Brewery, that for me trumps this one. A very lovely beer. Very, very nice beer. This one wasn't quite there. It was a little bit on the thin side. Didn't quite display the Citra Hop as well as the Oakham Brewery's version of their Citra. That being said, a very pleasant beer. And to be honest, you can't go wrong with the Citra Hop. Do you know what I mean? Quite nice and refreshing. Not Christmassy at all, really. But it's nice to have something that's got a bit of British tradition. And I get to see another brewery. So the Mighty Oak Brewery, this one was. Brewed in Essex. So yeah, it's nice to try something a little bit different. Quite like that. So where were we? Number 9. So we're on number 10 now. Ooh, not far to go now. Right. Yes. Delicious. Extra special bit. I think it was this one that I really liked. I like this one. Gave this one 8.2 out of 10. Jeeves is a Barnsley Brewing Company. They do a Christmas beer, Jeeves, as well, which is divine. I love it. Absolutely divine. This was an extra special bitter. Just packed full of British hops. 4.8% vol. Just a really nice beer. Really nice, solid British brewing. Just be careful, Jeeves. I'm just looking at your artwork. Very similar to the Welbeck Brewery artwork. So don't get yourself copyrighted for that. But yeah, absolutely fantastic. An excellent beer. I really enjoyed that. It's great to have a nice British beer. Nice earthy hops in it. And do you know what? It did actually taste quite festive. Because it was nice. It's nice. You don't get many British beers, yeah. British bitters. And I think that there's going to be a comeback for milds and British bitters, I'm telling you. I think the craft brewing scene is going to get onto that one pretty quick. So, yeah. Just double check. I've definitely had... done all these and I've missed out. Yeah, that one. Yeah, so we definitely have gone through these. Yeah. Now. Yes. Now, I've not quite given this as much as I thought I did. But this was a cracking beer. And more importantly, it was a mild. We don't get many milds these days. But a Christmassy or a festive, a full-bodied mild is very festive, I think. This was by the Drone Valley Brewery called Candle Riggs. Strong mild, 1909. 5.8%. Now, a lot of people will be used to drinking milds as quite a low percentage volume because they were traditionally brewed for workers, factory workers, so they could neck a couple of pints, then go back to work afterwards and not get the effect of the alcohol, but still drink the beer. But that's not, it's mild is actually meant, it's mild in hop character, not mild in alcoholic volume. So this was nice to have a full sort of volumed up strong mild, really nice beer, full of flavour, just cracking, loads of dark fruit, a little bit roasted, nice body to it. Yeah, I can't tell you everything because I can't remember. I can't smell anything now because my nose is bunged up. So yeah, last but not least, was Newsome Noel Christmas IPA. And I gave this one, 7.6 out of 10. So it's still a very good beer. But I think it's the second weakest one in the box, this one. But when I think about this IPA, this one's just like leagues above this one. And I think this one, it's been filtered. It was a little bit thin. I think it would have been nice to have an unfiltered. It's nice to, especially at Christmas, having them unfiltered. And it's not Christmassy. And that IPA did not, there was nothing Christmassy about this beer at all. At least with this one, it had a bit of character to it. You know, you've got the artwork, but almost a bit like, you know, it almost looks a bit ancient England, you know, King Arthur or something like that. This one, just a bit of yuppie artwork on it. Yuppie artwork. Just a bit of, gotta talk rubbish sometimes, just a bit of like bog standard quirky graphic designer artwork on it. It for me, it was, the artwork's minimalistic. For an IPA, it was relatively minimal. It was nice enough. I drunk it. Would I drink it on cask if I saw it? Yes, I would. It weren't very Christmassy though, and it annoys me when IPAs call themselves a Christmas IPA when they're not, nothing to do with Christmas. There we got the Christmas box set there. Would I get that again for £25? I would definitely get that again for £25. There was lots of some cracking beers in that. Absolute cracking beers. So thank you for watching. Thank you for, if you've had a Christmas box set, if you've had one from, this one came from Elsica, which is a bottle shop located near me. It's an heritage centre. They have like little steam trains running around and all that sort of stuff. So brilliant bottle shop. They have loads of continental beers in there as well. They're quite a good competitive prices for a bottle shop as well. So yeah, there we go. That's, I'm not going to go on anymore, but thanks for watching. Sorry I can't do a proper review this week. My nose is blocked up. I can't do a proper review when I feel like this. And I'll see you next time. Bye.